Hello friends, welcome to this episode of Science for Common Man. Today's topic is GPS. Let's understand what is GPS, how do we find our location using this system, why data from minimum 4 satellites are required for getting our location, and why accuracy improves further when we get data from more than 4 satellites, and what is the role of relativistic time dilation here. Let's get into it straight away, and I am bound to keep the explanation as simple as possible. Global Positioning System or GPS is a constellation of currently 31 satellites orbiting at an altitude of 20,200 km above Earth. The orbits are arranged in such a way that at least 6 satellites are always within line of sight from anywhere on Earth's surface. These satellites are launched and managed by US Department of Defense, but the data from these satellites can be used freely by anybody anywhere in Earth with some regulations. And what is that data? Each satellite continuously transmits the data, which contains its precise location and the time at which this data is sent from the satellite. And the service of the satellites end there. Rest all is done by the small GPS-enabled device which you have with you. In your device, hardware for receiving satellite data and software for decoding and processing that would be there. Let's say I am at this location which I do not know, and I am switching on GPS function in my device. My device starts receiving data from satellites which are in line of sight. Let's say I received data from this satellite. This data includes the position of satellite and the time at which the data was sent. And this data is actually in the form of electromagnetic waves which travel at a speed of 3 lakh km per second. So, I know the time at which it was sent and the speed at which it travels. Now, I look at the time in my clock when I receive the data and compare this with the time at which data was sent, and I can easily find the time it took for the data to travel and reach me from satellite. Let's say it took 0.08 seconds to reach from this satellite. I know that in 1 second it travels 3 lakh km, so I can find out that in 0.08 seconds, it would have traveled 24,000 km. That means, now I know that I am 24,000 km away from this particular satellite, but still I do not know where I am. So, if I make a sphere with this satellite as center and 24,000 km as radius, I can say that I am lying somewhere on the surface of the sphere. Now, I look for a second satellite and I find that I am 23,000 km away from this satellite, and I construct another sphere like this, and as per data from second satellite, I am lying on the surface of that sphere too. I look for a third satellite and I construct third sphere, and I should be on that sphere too. So there are 3 spheres and I am on the surface of all of them, which means that I am on the point where these 3 spheres meet together. That means I should be either on the red dot or blue dot, which are the intersections of the spheres. Since the blue dot is in deep space and impossible location, I can confirm my position as the red dot, and yes, I found my location. Are we successful? Well, in this procedure, we relied too much on the timing of clocks of 3 satellites and our device. We assume that they are perfectly synchronized. In reality, we know that if we look at 3 or 4 different clocks, we would find small differences in the individual times. Here, we were working on a travel time of around 0.08 seconds. An error of even 0.0001 second will give an error in distance by 30 km. Luckily, all satellites have very expensive and accurate atomic clocks which are synchronized to nanoseconds, and our worry should be only about the clock of our device. It is not feasible to put costly atomic clocks in our device either. Now, what is the solution? Let us accept that we are working with an inaccurate clock which has a drift from the time of atomic clocks in the satellite. Now, if I can know this drift, I can offset the time data in my calculation by the amount of drift and get good result. Let's say the clock in my device is running early by 0.01 second, which I do not know. Now, I find all distances lesser by 3000 km, which also I do not know. Now, I decide to look to fourth satellite and create a fourth sphere like this using the data from fourth satellite. Now we have four spheres. Ideally, in case of a zero drift, these four should give a common intersection and that would be my location. But now, because there is a drift in my clock, I get different positions when I use a combination of any three of these satellites to find my location. And the offset between these points is an indication of error in the time of my device. Now, I start adjusting the time of my clock, or in effect, the radii of spheres, in such a way that all these four spheres intersect at a single point. Yes, that is my location, and the time adjustment that I have done to get this is my time drift. In fact, what we have done here is that we overcame our shortcoming of having an inaccurate clock by using the data from fourth satellite. And this is why we need data from minimum four satellites to find the location. But in certain cases, three satellites also would work. For example, if I already know that I am on the surface of Earth, Earth itself becomes one sphere, and using other three satellite spheres, I can find my location. Normally, GPS has an accuracy of around 8 meters. Still, there are some errors due to refraction and speed variation of electromagnetic waves when they pass through different layers of atmosphere, multipath signals, etc. These errors can be minimized further by taking data from 5th and 6th satellites, and thus adding more and more satellites will improve the accuracy. In fact, there are more things to take care. Theory of relativity says that the passage of time is different for two objects if they have relative speed or if they are subjected to different gravities, and both the conditions are applicable for all satellites. The satellites move very fast compared to receiver, and so there is relative speed. The gravity on satellite is lesser compared to receiver, since gravity reduces with height, and so there is difference in gravity also. The higher speed makes satellite clock slower by 7 microseconds per day, and lower gravity makes it faster by 45 microseconds per day. So net effect is that the satellite clocks run faster by 38 microseconds per day. If unaccounted, this will induce an error of 11.5 km per day in position. This is how it works. And the interesting part is that for receiving data from satellites and finding our location, we don't need an internet connection or a mobile network coverage. But having an internet connection or mobile network coverage will surely help you know what the things other than you at the location are. Pre-installed data can also be used for this. GPS is owned by US. There are similar systems managed by other countries also. That's it for today. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe and support us. Signing off, Science for Common Man.